guys, welcome back to my channel, Minzil Biology. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the lethal alleles and what are lethal alleles. So if we say some of the genes are very essential to our survival, if there is any mutation in the allele of the gene, then it can lead to the death of an organism. So that mutation in that specific allele that is very essential for our survival is known as lethal allele. That when we have mutated the allele, it had led to the death of the organism. So what is lethal allele? Lethal allele is the mutation in an allele or gene that is essential for the survival of organism. So due to lethal gene, death of the organism occurs. Death of the organism occurs. Okay. So lethal allele can be of two types. It can be of dominant lethal allele. It can be of dominant lethal allele. Or it can be recessive lethal allele. It can be recessive lethal allele. So, if we consider dominant lethal allele, then in dominant lethal allele, one allele is sufficient for the death of the organism. It can work in heterozygous condition also. In this condition as well as in this condition, if mutation has occurred dominant, if the mutation is dominant lethal allele, then one allele mutation is enough. Okay, so it can also work in heterozygous condition. But in recessive allele, homozygous condition is very necessary. Until and unless homozygous condition is not present, the organism will not get the disease and it won't get killed. It will survive. So only homozygous condition will lead to the recessive lethal gene condition. So it works only in homozygous condition and it works only in heterozygous condition. For example, if we take in dominant lethal allele, if I take the example of Huntington's disease, then this disease is caused by a dominant autosomal disease. It is a dominant autosomal disease. So what happened in this dominant autosomal is mutated. This dominant autosomal allele is mutated. Due to which the death of organism will occur. Okay, because this is a progressive disorder of brain. There is a progressive disorder in the brain of the organism occurs. That's why the death of the organism occurs. So this is a dominant lethal allele condition. That is a Huntington disease. While in recessive lethal allele, the example is cystic fibrosis. Cystic fibrosis. Until and unless both the allele are mutated, the organism will not get the disease. The organism will only get the disease when both the alleles are mutated. If this condition is present, then the organism will be carrier and it will survive. It will be diseased only when it has both the allele mutated. What happens in cystic fibrosis? That there is a deposition of mucus, sweat, digestive juices occurs, deposition occurs in the body. So this is cystic fibrosis, this is a recessive lethal allele and this is a dominant lethal allele. Now you must make it confused that dominant lethal alleles always occurs on the dominant allele and recessive lethal allele will occurs in always recessive allele. For example, if we see in detail, like there are two alleles. This one is dominant allele and this one is recessive allele. If we normally consider that it is a dominant allele and it is a recessive allele. So what we think that if a mutation occurred in this disease, in this allele, then it will be dominant lethal allele. And if a mutation has occurred in this allele, then it will be recessive lethal allele. But that's not the condition. For example, if we take an example of a mice, an experiment was done on this mice. What was done that two mice with yellow color, two heterozygous mice with yellow color were crossed. With yellow color were crossed and the offsprings were YY, YY, YY and small y, small y. Out of these four mice, this mice wasn't able to survive and the death of this mice occurred while all these mice were able to survive. So what happened that this specifically mice was dead? Because it has capital Y, but these two also has capital Y. And if dominant lethal allele was the condition, then heterozygous must also dead. But this condition, these two survive and this is dead. So this occurred because of the recessive lethal allele. That the recessive lethal allele has occurred on the dominant allele for the characteristic. It is a dominant allele for the characteristic, but for lethal allele, it is recessive lethal allele. It will show the disease, it will show the death only when both the dominant characteristic allele are mutated. If only one is mutated, the organism will not die. The organism may get some diseases like diabetes, it may get obesity, but it will survive. But it will survive, it will be not die. But when this condition occurs, the organism will be dead. So this is recessive lethal allele occurred on the dominant characteristic allele. It was dominant for characteristic, but it is recessive for the lethal allele. So this was yellow, these two were yellow, and this was white. And the death of this mice is occurred. So I hope this video helped you a lot. Thank you so much for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and share this video with your friends.